Today I'm going to go over our free template, which was a matte template. And if you want the free matte template, then just go to email sign up and click sign up, and then you will be redirected to a link and you'll opt in a second time, and then you'll be directed to our free templates and you'll get this matte template along with several other free templates. But today I'm going to talk about how to use this matte template. First, I want to move this out of the way. Now, this is the matte template that we're going to work on today, and right now it has the pictures placed. I've had a couple people mention that sometimes when I just start by having things already done, that it's a little bit overwhelming because they want to know every detail. I do go over in my earlier tutorials how to bring a picture into a Photoshop template, adjust the layers and move them up and down. So I try to move things along quickly so that you can learn these things quickly. So if you need to know how to drag a picture in, work with the layers, I suggest you go to my website and you click on free tutorials. And then you arrow down to the bottom here and click on adding a picture to a magazine template, and this will actually show you how to add a picture to any template. And then if you want to know more about changing fonts and colors on templates, then I suggest you watch this second tutorial here. All right, let's get this out of the way and let's start moving along. So I've already got my pictures placed in here, and my pictures are right here in this layer. And if I click on this to arrow it down, and I arrow down, you can see these are my three pictures. Okay, so what I've done on this template is I've added some adjustment layers, and I'm going to arrow that down, and I just added some adjustment layers that you can play around with to make changes to your pictures. And as long as these adjustments are above these picture layers, they're going to have effects on these pictures. So if I turn them off, you'll see that my pictures change back to color. And if I turn them on, you'll see that they change to black and white with a little bit of a yellow tint. So basically, you can just double click on these and you can just play with them and watch how they make your photos change. And there's all kinds of adjustments you can do, changing the curves here. So that's something that's kind of fun to play with. And then the levels, and you move these back and forth. And the black and white, and then you can also add yellow. You can just change, it removes colors, even though you can't see the colors off. Now you know how that works. Okay, so I've added a hue and saturation to the textured and the smooth mattes. I'm just going to work with the textured one right now. So basically you just double click on this, and as you watch, you can change the color of the matte. As you just slide the hue back and forth, and it's a little bit muted, which sometimes looks nice for mattes, but if you wanted it to be brighter, then you could just increase the saturation and then again move the hue, and you can see it changing the colors, and then you can even make it darker. So it's kind of fun to play with. When layers have hue, saturation, and adjustments, then you can just easily make changes, match the, you know, some colors in the picture. I'm going to go ahead and cancel this. And I also just want to show you how you can add this to any layer. So let's say you have a frame and you want to add a hue, saturation layer so that you can change the color, and I'm just gonna go ahead and throw this away. Okay, so the easiest way to add a hue saturation adjustment layer is to click on this little tool right here, come up to Hue Saturation, and then click OK. Come to the layer, right-click it, and click Create Clipping Mask. Then you can double-click your Hue Saturation layer, and then you can just start sliding it and making the changes that you want. And that's how easy it is to make adjustments to your matte color and your photos. So I hope you enjoy the free template.